In the world of ground forces, there are many different vehicles to choose from. But in history, there are two countries that have been known for their tank support, dating back to even the First World War. And with the introduction of the Second World War, German and American tanks have always been a bit of rivals. But in the modern world, things are way different. And with that, we take Germany's famous Leopard 2 and stack it against the great American M1 Abrams. And to see what are the differences between them, what each one has and the other does not, and maybe ask the question, which one is better and which one is worse? How's it going, all you lovely viewers? My name is Dave Wapple, and welcome to FTD Facts, the channel where I look at people, countries, cultures, and in this case, we take different types of militaries and compare them to see what the differences are. Now, this is kind of a sequel video to our previous one where we talked about one of the versions of the Leopard 2, and that is the Stridvagn 122, which is Sweden's version of a Leopard 2, and man, it is dangerous. That being said, if you guys are big military buffs and you guys like learning about that sort of stuff, well, you want to check out some of our playlists. I'm going to put it down there in the description box below and in some of the cards throughout this video, which will be above my head at any time. Feel free to check them out. Now, starting off with the Leopard 2, it is what I like to call supreme German engineering. They know how to make cars, they know how to make tanks, they know how to make a lot of different things. Partially due to the fact that in the 80s, Germany decided to ignore the dot-com sort of internet stuff that America was focused on, and they went all with gear, technology, and that sort of thing. But as for the Leopard 2, it is basically a major improved version of the Leopard 1 tank. What I mean by that is they took the good aspects of the Leopard 1 and made a whole brand new tank. The Leopard 2 was introduced in 1979, and if you look at some of the Leopard 2s from around the world, you'll notice that some of them are a little bit different. This is because any version from the Leopard 2A4 and prior have more of a square-fronted turret, whereas the Leopard 2A5 and upward has more of a classy angled arrowhead sort of turret, which many may think might be better for deflections, but not necessarily true, and I'm going to get into that in this video. Now, what's very interesting about the Leopard 2 is that for Germany, when the Leopard 1 came out, they immediately knew that they already needed another new form of tank. And with that, around 1967, Germany had invested 30 million Deutschmarks into looking for a new design and upgrade. And on a side note, one of the major competitors that was a driving force for this new tank was the American and German-made MBT-70. Basically, they were like, we want to be able to match this thing or completely defeat it. And also on a side note, again, when it comes to the MBT-70, it's also a driving force for the Abrams, because America really wasn't happy with that tank either. The problem with the MBT-70, it was a big tank, it was very heavy, and of course, for both sides, it cost a lot. So Germany and America were like, we need to figure out ways to make a more cost-effective tank. And although America had introduced the tank known as the Xm803, these two tanks were canceled by America in 1971. And within that same year, funds were put into what was known as the Xm1 Abrams Program, which was named after General Crichton Abrams. Now, one thing I found very fascinating about the Leopard 1 and the Abrams was the fact that because of the amount of development that had gone into both of these tanks individually, in 1973, it was because of their past work, you got NATO standardization on tanks. The reason for that was because in 1973, German and American defense ministers decided that NATO should have a standardization for the tanks using technologies that were developed already from both programs. And by 1974, both countries had signed an agreement that these two tanks should be trialed against each other. And for the Leopard 2, it was on October 25th, 1979, that the government had accepted and received its first batch of 380, to be exact, Krauss-Maffei Leopard 2 tanks. And as for the Chrysler defense-made M1 Abrams, they came into service in 1980. Interesting enough, the original tank didn't have the 120mm gun that is on the tanks now. It had a 105mm cannon instead. But however, with that, the M1 Abrams was the first tank in the world to use what is known as Chobham Armor, which was very, very revolutionary for the time. The M1 Abrams proved to be so successful that from 1979 to 85, America had built 3,273 of these tanks. However, in 1986, they changed out the barrel to use the 120mm Rheinmetall barrel that was used very similarly on the Leopard 2. So now that we got a little bit of the history behind them, it's really quite interesting that they were both kind of brought up together. Whatever your thoughts on which one is better, I always like to think of the Leopard 2 and the Abrams kind of as brothers being raised in the same house. However, with that, let's get into variants. Let's talk about different things that are offered between different types. And of course, I'm not going to list off every single one because for the Leopard 2, it has at least 14 different versions that are currently out or are currently in production. One of the variants that is very unique compared to the rest of them that I really want to mention, and I did mention prior, is the Stridsvagn 122 or the Leopard 2S that Sweden makes. But however, one of the biggest changes was when the Leopard 2 came out with the Leopard 2A4. For this variant, there were major overhauls. They introduced an automated fire and explosion suppression system. There were also many upgrades that were taken from the 2A3. There was also a titanium tungsten armor upgrade. And basically from that moment on, the Leopard 2A4 became standard, and every vehicle prior became upgraded to that version. As a matter of fact, there are a lot of Leopard 2A4s that are around today simply because in the year 2000, Germany and the Netherlands had a lot of these in storage doing nothing and they decided, you know what, we got to sell these to other countries. However, I'm going to talk about operational history a little bit later. Because shortly after the 2A4 was introduced, they upgraded to the new 2A5, which got a major new look and design with the wedge arrowhead shape look. There were also new liners put inside the craft to prevent fragments from penetrating. Now, this new wedge-shaped design, a lot of people think, oh, it's, you know, made for more deflections. That's not necessarily true. The original base shape of the armor on the Leopard 2A4 is capable of deflecting quite well. The 2A5, I like to describe more or less as kind of a pillow or a cushion for incoming shots. Basically, it prevents incoming fire from hitting the armor base and causes the kinetic penetrators to change in direction or simply erode. There's a lot of science behind this whole thing, but from my understanding, the wedge shape is not made to make it go pew and deflect. After that, there was the introduction of the 2A6, which has enhanced mine protection and crew survivability enhancements. There were also many other upgrades that were pretty much considered now the standard. And of course, there's countries like Canada that have done major modifications to the 2A6 to make it their own. Also, the Stridsvagn 2S, going back to that, it's considered one of the most armored versions of a Leopard 2. There's also the Leopard 2A7 and the A7 Plus, which recently Qatar and Hungary have been considered the largest buyers of this variant. The M1A1, however, has 28 different versions. However, keep in mind there are 7 major ones, but only 3 of those are realistically practical use, where the other ones are more experimental. And those 3 are the M1, the M1A1, and the M1A2. For example, under the M1A1, it has 10 versions alone, including the original. The M1A2 has 7, including its original as well, in which some of them are still under development. For the M1A1, however, there were many different upgrades, but one of the biggest one was the barrel that I was talking about. This one began production in 1985, and that's when they added the 120 smoothbore cannon. On top of that, they also upgraded the NBC system, improved stowage, and of course, redesigned the blow-off panels. However, the M1A2, which is more or less the common one that we see today, it brought in an independent thermal sight for the tank commanders, meaning that it could shoot at 2 targets at once without the need to acquire one individually. Do not ask me how that works. That seems like you have 2 eyes looking in 2 different directions. It also added the very updated and extraordinarily tough depleted uranium armor components, which also have graphite coating on them. They also improved the counter IED armor, improved on the FLIR abilities, added passive ballistic protection to some other versions on the M1A2's turret, and of course there were much more. It's quite an impressive list. As for one of the newer ones, which is the M1A3, it is considered still in development and there's not a lot of information about it. Alright, so now that we got variants out of the way, let's look at the operational history. For the Leopard 2 tank, it is operated within 18 different countries. These are the countries of Austria, Canada, Chile, Denmark, Finland, Germany, of course, Greece, Indonesia, the Netherlands, which that one is a little bit tricky to understand because they've gotten rid of a lot of their tanks, but they do have a division that's linked with a German unit, so that's kind of how it works. There's also Norway, Poland, Portugal, Qatar, Singapore, Spain, Sweden, Switzerland. Switzerland also don't really have any of them. They put most of them in storage, from my understanding. They're going more for wheeled, tracked kind of vehicles. And last but not least, let's not forget the country of Turkey. For the M1 Abrams, it is operated in far less countries, equaling 7. These are the countries of Australia, Egypt, Iraq, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, Morocco, and of course, the United States of America. However, when it comes to the amount of these tanks being built, let's be real, there's far more Abrams around the world than there are Leopard 2s. Although it is hard to get an accurate figure of how many of these have been made, for the Leopard 2, they say there is greater than 3,200 of them been made, and for the M1 Abrams, they say there's approximately 10,288. All right, let's move right along. Let's look at some of the statistics. Now, the Leopard 2 for armor has what is known as third generation composite, including high hardness steel, tungsten, and plastic filler with ceramic components. The M1A2, however, uses what is known as depleted uranium mesh reinforced composite armor. As for armaments, the Leopard 2 uses the 1x120mm smoothbore Rheinmetall with approximately 42 rounds. On top of that, it has a 2x762 German-made MG3 with approximately 4,750 rounds. The M1A2, however, also uses the 120mm smoothbore Rheinmetall gun with 42 rounds as well. And with machine guns, they have the exact same amount, 2x of them, using the same caliber that is 7.62. However, they use the M240. One major upside of the M1A1, it has more machine gun rounds, coming in at 10,400. Speed, however, the Leopard 2 is a little bit faster, but not by much. This is because the Leopard 2 comes in at 68 kilometers per hour at its best, and the M1A2 comes in at 67 kilometers per hour. Keep in mind, that is on road, that is not off road doing anything crazy like that. It is much slower. Of course, also with the operational range, it is far less for the Leopard 2, coming in at 340 kilometers, whereas the Leopard M1A2 with its gas tanks can come in at 436 kilometers. And for some of the technical statistics, for the Leopard 2A6, it is manned by a crew of 4. It has a length of 10.97 meters, with a width of 3.76 meters and a height of 3.03 meters. Its combat weight comes in at 62.5 tons, and its turret rotation of 360 degrees can be done in 9 to 10 seconds. Looking now at the M1A2 SEP version of the Abrams, it is crewed with 4 individuals. It also has a length of 9.77 meters, being a little bit smaller. It's also a bit smaller in width, coming in at 3.7 meters, and much smaller in its height at 2.4 meters. Its combat weight is a little bit heavier at 63 tons, and for its turret rotation 360 degrees, it is said to be anywhere between 9 to 10 seconds as well. See what I mean by they're kind of like brothers? They kind of are capable of doing the same thing. It's kind of interesting. And to finish it all off, when it comes to cost, for a Leopard 2A6 in 2007, it came in at $5.74 million, where an M1A2, at least in 1999, came in at $6.21 million. So there you have it, guys. That's me looking at these two great, amazing tanks. What are your thoughts on it? Do you think one is better than the other? I can definitely say this. There are more Abrams out there in the world than there are Leopard 2s. Either way, before you guys get out of here, be sure to check out our military playlist. They're going to be down there in the description box below, up there in the boxes, or at the end of this one. And speaking of down there, while you guys are down there in the comments section, you might as well leave a thought on your favorite one. And of course, probably while you're down there, you might as well leave us a suggestion for a future comparison video, or just any type of video that you want us to learn and teach you guys and teach other people about. My name is Dave Wapple. I will see you guys in the next one. It's been awesome hanging out with you. Bye-bye. Okay, guys, so here are those videos that I was telling you about. Be sure to check out these playlists. You guys are going to like learning about different militaries around the world. It's good to be educated, you know what I mean? So feel free to check them out. I will see you guys later. Bye.